Welcome to Isis in the Bible, the winter gathering, week number 12, Easter. The question for today is, what does in the blink of an eye mean to you? Are you ready to watch the whole world change in the blink of an eye? The system of force, aka lack of love, is opposite of acceleration, which is the gravity of love. We will accelerate with love in a blink of an eye. Glad you could join us today. So we did talk about that and went around the room and got some beautiful vibrations from everybody on their thoughts about what blink of an eye is. We'll share that. A little bit of advertising for our spirit groups. Hope you guys can join us on April the 7th from noon to 1:30 p.m. We're going to have our celebration. If you're interested, please email Nancy at spiritgroups@unitycanada.org. We would like to show up and give us your input and where you're at with your spirituality and what you're noticing and how it's all going, and help make this a fun event and meet others from other spirit groups. Hope you can join us. Okay, a couple from the Isis in the Bible gang about this topic. Since they responded, I'm going to put it up here. Aye, aye, Captain. The sails are set. Much love and gratitude by Brother John. And then Sister Rachel, she said, in the blink of an eye, when we blink, both eyes blink, not just one. So my interpretation is that everyone's pineal gland, third eye, is going to open. Some to heaven on earth, some to hell on earth. But love is the key, for all things must happen in three. Three blind mice, see how they run. They all run after the farmer's wife who cut off their whiskers with a carving knife. Have you ever seen such anything in your life as three blind mice? Ready to see and help as many as possible. Awesome comments. Okay, so as you know, we've been talking about what's coming up and happening in the sky. And I just wanted to re-mention that the 26th, where Eris, the mother of all mothers, divine love, meets with the principal of your report card, Mercury. So I wanted to, there's quite a few things that happen on that day, but something really interesting happened on that day. And I'm not sure if you guys heard about in Baltimore, a ship hit a bridge and it came crashing down. Well, right at the time that it hit, so I went and pulled the chart up at 1:28. And here's what's happening. Right overhead, that which eclipses the moon and the sun with the moon on the midheaven in Virgo. This is Mother Mary. She's giving signs. She's talking to us. She's saying, hey, everyone, let's pay attention to the signs. So that happened on the 26th. This is the way Mother Nature communicates with us. So somebody did not have a good day, whoever was driving this ship, right? I'm not sure if you guys have seen this. So just going to play it, minute and a half. I'll speed it up so the thing goes and it like spins, like it's, look at it. It spins around and comes like right at it. So it's not done intentionally. It just happens. A lot of people are going to take a time out in their busy lives. They need to not cross that bridge right now. Go home, take it easy. Because we're running our butts off, you know what I'm saying? We're what are we doing? We're stuck in the material world. And that whole system is gonna collapse. London Bridge is falling down, right? So this is happening in the sky. We gotta pay attention. And this group is paying attention, and many others are. But when you see that they're lined up to give us signs, it's incredible. It's absolutely beautiful. We're infinite. If there's anybody that left the visible on that day, they're infinite, taking one for the team. All right. And then I just wanted to show you that. So there was a flood in Kenya. 1,100 families in the slums were affected. I mean, look at these people. They're this is what they're doing in their day, right? Changing their lives. But look at the systems we make. Look at the places we're building. It's time for us to change. And we have to change it within a blink of an eye. Because we're not thinking. We're building all these structures, even every city around the world. Guess what happens? They're going to go live in them when we leave. Well, we got to make sure everybody's included when we make. And at that time, when the rain started that causes the flood, at 7 p.m., Virgo was rising. In a messenger, I can't remember if it was just one-on-ones or if it was the whole group, but we noticed a whole bunch of things with Virgo, right? This is Mother Mary's home. All right, so I just wanted to show you. We call this Isis in the Bible for a reason, because the Bible is about the stars and your journey. How do you read the stars? Well, from the micro, you read them from the cardinal points. Susan, here's your cat showing you the backyard, which has a bunch of cardinals, and the Vatican and the cardinal, right? Because the Vatican has cardinals in it. People's day that day. So if you look at the midheaven, this is one of the, and it's just going to go by the minutes. Watch how fast this goes. See the midheaven. Okay, so there it is with Venus. So you might have saw something to do with Mother Nature, right? Oh, and then it hits Neptune, and Neptune brings pain, right? So if you had a little ache somewhere, and then there's Hygieia, a cleanse, so you could have sneezed. Oh, somebody talking about your wings, right? Because that's Icarus. And then the sun, that's you, feeling the warmth of the sun. And then the eclipse, there's your conscious thoughts, okay? And then there's Chiron, the wounded healer. And then there's Mama with Mercury. These actual energies do affect us, and they all become absolutely invigorating the more and more we connect with Mother Nature and have that love. So interesting, though, I remember today to go back and look, because I stuck my finger in my top drawer and I hit a compass, one of these points. I go, ow! So I immediately took a snapshot on my phone so I can remember what time it was. And I didn't remember to look until now. So look at what's on the cardinal point. The ascendant was dry. Don't forget, this goes by in minutes. So I stuck my finger here. Pain was still there, and then it went away. It's a compass. We're going to talk about the cardinal points today. Susan sees cardinals. The Vatican used to have cardinals in it because they knew how to read exactly what I'm telling you. We're so connected, and Mother Nature is telling us we're connected, and the animals are jumping down in the background. For those of you that didn't know, Judy's cat's jumping up and down in the background, saying, hey, pay attention, because we're going to be talking. And then Susan says about her daughter's cat jumping over to the neighbor's yard, which complained because they have a bunch of cardinals there, and they call it the Vatican City with all the cardinals in their backyard. And here we are. I had no idea that was going to be said today, and here's what I'm talking about. The compass holds the cardinal points. This is a compass. I got stung by the compass's point, and we're talking about the cardinals today. They're telling us to pay attention. The animals are guiding us every step of the way, and it's absolutely beautiful. So yesterday, while we're having our Unity Canada meeting, my wife Kathy calls me, hey, babe, come here. And these two beautiful animals, Anima, they were walking up the front lawn and onto our front porch. These are wild turkeys, if people don't know what they are. So I went and looked this morning. This is the time of the photograph. They stayed for 4, 5, 6 minutes. There's the ascendant, the cardinal point. Going by who? Lilith, which is the cat. Lilith represents temptations. The turkeys are asking us to pay attention. And the cats just told us all about the cardinals for today. And the cardinal point, and the cats and the turkeys are talking. I know what the message from the turkeys is saying. We have Easter coming. Those turkeys want to be on your front porch, nowhere else in your house. I hope you can catch my drift. They're communicating with us. The turkey should not be in a warm place in your oven. The turkeys need to be alive so they can show you how to make your way back home to love. So you just witnessed a whole bunch of people coming here. For the people that are on YouTube watching this, what happened before we showed this video was absolutely orchestrated by the cats and the turkeys. It's absolutely beautiful. So our temptation for the Easter is love versus love. Let's be loving. All right, and here's another synchronicity. Judy mentioned this, and this is Kat brought this up. And it's about the 100 monkey effect. The 100 monkey effect, sleep is like a blink of an eye. When you go to sleep at night, you close your eyes and you open them. That blink, it felt like you were asleep for 10 seconds and then you're awake. It's the exact same thing between heartbeats, between breaths, between your blinking your eyes. We connect with that beautiful, loving spirit. When we leave the visible, we come back in a blink of an eye. We have no idea how much time, whether it was a day, 2 days, 10 days, 3 days that they say in the Bible, a year or 10 years. It's a blink of an eye for us. And then we come back. You can't stay in the light unless you're pure love. So we got some work to do. Anyway, Book of 1 Corinthians, Judy read this and Kat said it, which says, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall all be changed. And this is happening. And the animals are showing us the anima. The anima means soul, soul animals, like on the Egyptian walls. So I just want to mention this. Kat says, like the Jimmy Morrison song, break on through to the other side. Look at that beautiful image that AI came up with, right? As above, so below. There's a phoenix rising happening in the sky and a reflection of mama with her baby. When the sun is rising in the east, the true Easter is happening on April 14th. The mother rises with the sun. That's Easter. When she rises in the east, and us being on this revelation path where we just witnessed today the anima talking with us is part of that blink of an eye, the revelation that we're all one and we're connected. We have to connect. We have to love. We got to change our ways. That's the sign we're getting. Break on through to the other side, says Kat. All right. Couple of feel goods before we end her up. I'm not sure if you've seen this little video, but check this out. While observing this little kitty, he does look like he breaks on through to the other side. Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. So everyone just chill. It's all going to happen with a blink of an eye. Like the cat watching everything go by, everything that he sees goes by in a blink of an eye, right? So, okay. So here's just a quick song and we're done for the day.
I felt my heartbreak jump. I felt adrenaline pump. The second that I saw you walk in, a little voice inside said, better hold on tight. Get ready, set, go, you're gonna fall again. How fast is a speeding bullet? How fast can Superman fly? How long does a shooting star race across the sky? How fast can a dream come true? All I know is one look at you and I fell in the blink of an eye.
temperature burn. I felt the whole world turn, like gravity was pulling your heart to mine. When you looked at me like that, quicker than a finger snap, I saw you and me forever in record time. How fast is a speeding bullet? How fast can Superman fly? How long does a shooting star race across the sky? How fast can a dream come true? All I know is one look at you, and I fell in the blink of an eye. How fast is a ricocheting bullet? Superman fly. How fast can a dream come true? All I know is one look at you, and I fell in the blink of an eye.
Take it, baby.
How fast can a dream come true?
In the blink of an eye.
How fast can I fall for you?
And that's all we have for today.